My dad, Mario Vara, rest in peace. You know, I was very close to my dad growing up. My dad, to this day, it's very hard to talk about his death or, you know, to really deal with it because it's been quite some time since he's been gone, but it's very, it's a hard thing because my dad was not just my dad. I always say he was my best friend, my best friend.
I have a call back for 866-2-7. Negative K, nothing further, just take care of me in the corner.
Witnessing is our Rochester police officers taking out a clear retaliation to the case of Emily Good. Ironically, the timing couldn't be any more interesting while we're having a meeting for Emily Good. Basically, four cruisers have pulled up to the scene of the squirrel and have basically pulled out rulers and have ticketed several vehicles. And this is how the Rochester police gets down.
All right, so again, some of this conversation was started from a videotape, which has reached a level of circulation around the web, from a woman who was standing on her front lawn videotaping four police officers in a would-be drug bust that turned into nothing.
So they find it more necessary to spend their tax dollars and their force of officers to come and harass because their cars are parked, you know, a half a day, and then are you kidding me? You know, I'm so saying that's the problem that's going on in this community, that there are too many people finding it, more convenient to do their death dumb and blind, you know, and it's sad. It's like a lot of people say it doesn't have anything to do with me, so I'm not going to get involved. And that's the problem.
Top black. police out for now fight. Ice Cube will swarm on any motherfucker in the booth. Just cause I'm from the CPT. Police. A young nigga on the warpath. And when I finish, it's gonna be a bloodbath of cops dying in LA. Yo, Dre, I got something to say.
Fuck the motherfucking police. They don't want peace. They want a nigga deceased, so he'll cease to be a problem. And by the way they perform, it seems the Klan gave the white police another uniform. And you're the black police, the house niggas. They gave you a motherfucking gun, so I guess you figure you made out good to go. But you didn't know they were sticking black ass back in the ghetto, yo, to kill another nigga, catch him with crack. In fact, freebase, they put in the neighborhood in the first place. But the brothers ain't stupid. Remember that. You gotta get, I gotta get. So what's up with that? Shooting everything in sight. Tonight's the night to get hype and fight for what's wrong, fuck what's right. And by the way, my name is Dre, so listen up, motherfuckers, to what I gotta say. Yo, fuck the police. Fuck the police.
Fuck the police. Fuck the police. Now for the first episode.
Yeah, that shit's hitting, man. Where the volume on this motherfucker?
Hold on, one time.
Put the joint up. Joint.
Hey, you motherfuckers wanna step out the car? Let's get some motherfucking music. Shut the fuck up. Go to jail? Well, give me that shit you was just smoking.
Motherfuckers that come from high crime areas view the police as a threat. And that's some shit you better not forget.
Easy, a name feared by most. When a little nigga is thrown in the pen, but on the streets there's two kinds of people. White rich fucks and the ones who get harassed like me. Pull over to the side of routine for me. Tan up my shit like they're looking for a key of cocaine. But they never find the shit. Ain't got nothing better to do and nobody else to fuck with. Thinking everything is stolen. But can't face facts that a young black nigga's just rolling. Making more money than they ever make. Taking more shit than they ever take. Yo, Big's a major kill. Ain't no regretting. Keep your hand on your weapon. Shoot his ass and start stepping. Cause I'm a nigga that don't give a fuck about nothing. So let me explain a little something, yo.
See, I got this problem. A big problem. Cops don't like me, so I'm like motherfucking cops.
Car.
Wait a goddamn minute, what the hell did I do?
Hey, just shut the fuck up, black bitch.
Wait a minute, you ain't got to put me by my motherfucking hair.
Hey, just step the fuck back.
Get your motherfucking hair off of me.
Calm down. Listen, we're going to go around this corner, and you're going to suck me and my partner's dicks, or you're going to be one black, dead nigger bitch.
Police brutality is common in my neighborhood. That's why I hate the motherfuckers.
I've said fuck the police, but with a little more force. And maybe now I get my point across. There's a massacre going on. Just open your eyes and look. Every day a young nigga is took off the face of the streets by police. It's like they got a nigga chained on a short leash. You can't leave out the city that's just jacked up. Cause if you do left or right, they got this jacked up. It's embarrassing because you know they just. But all you can do is say fuck this. Because if you move, that's all she wrote. So with the excuse to shoot, or would rather stomp your head till you're dead with the steel toe boot. Harassing me with some kind of mind game, acting like a nigga just was born with a gang name. You call that rights, but when you're black, there's no rights. And recreational shit was only in gang fights. And shooting at the cops was a street thing to waste time as we slanged off the cocaine. But everything was done just for peace, to retaliate on the fucking police. So I'm saying,
policías, güeyes, pendejos, salvajes, culeros.
They just sit back from the back.
And, you know, I was very close to my dad growing up. My dad, to this day, it's very hard to talk about his death or, you know, to really deal with it because it's been quite some time since he's been gone, but it's very, it's a hard thing because my dad was not just my dad. I always say he was my best friend, my best friend, my best friend.